Hello students. Today's class is on HelpAge India, Objectives, Functions and Programs. This lesson is about HelpAge India's organization and its aims and objectives. It also explains the features and programs of HelpAge India, which is working for the destitute, poor and marginalized sections of India's older population. On the completion of this lesson, you should be able to understand the aim and objectives of HelpAge India, analyze the functions and programs of HelpAge India, and also know the role of HelpAge India in care and protection of India's older population. Non-governmental organizations. The term non-governmental organizations refer to a structure that works to fill the gaps in the function of government for the welfare of the people of the society and the nation. However, government tries its best to fulfill its different roles, such as policy development, regulation, facilitation, management and internal sustainability, but there still remains scope for some loopholes and vulnerabilities to take place in the process of advancement. This process of improvement is not only limited to economic growth and prosperity among the people, but it also implies the growth and inclusion of few other significant factors which not only facilitate the development, but also help in manifesting a sustainable growth of the nation. Now, such factors include social growth, social justice, awareness, empowerment of the citizens, equality, preservations of human rights, uplifting the underprivileged and disadvantaged sectors of the society, promotion of education, women welfare, health sector, and promoting humanitarian causes among the citizens of the society. Now, let's see little more about HelpAge India. One of the premier non-governmental organizations that began work on the cause of India's older population is HelpAge India, a secular, a political, non-profit organization. Founding of HelpAge India in 1978 and the World Assembly on Aging in 1982 have been responsible for creating greater awareness of the needs of the growing number of older persons in the country. HelpAge India and its founding organization, Help the Aged, which is from United Kingdom, have made a signal contribution towards the development of variety of services for the elderly in India. Help the Aged, founded by a group of British businessmen headed by the late Cecil Jackson Cole, who was closely associated with the General Development Agency, formed since its original as the Oxford Committee for Famine Relief during the Second World War in 1960s. The group had noted that no agency existed to meet the needs of the elderly in the disaster situations, and discussions with the United Nations confirmed this lack of services. Thus, Help the Aged came into being in 1960. In 1978, Help the Aged took the initiative to start an independent agency to work for the cause of the elderly in India, which resulted in the formation of HelpAge India as a registered society with Indian and overseas members in the organization. It mobilizes substantial resources in India for supporting various programs for the welfare of the elderly through non-governmental organizations. Formation of HelpAge India in 1978 marked the beginning of professional fundraising and project advisory services, thus accelerating non-governmental efforts in promoting services for the elderly. The partnership between Center for the Welfare of the Aged, HelpAge India and Help an Aged UK led to the development of a pioneering project at Chennai under the auspice of Center for the Welfare of the Aged in 1979 to experiment with alternate elder care models to help strengthen the integration of the elderly in the community in which they live through day centers, domiciliary care, family counseling, social work with elderly patients in hospitals, and income maintenance through assistance for self-employment, skill upgradation, and group income generating activities. Initially, day centers for the elderly in India were set up during 1979-80 by Center for the Welfare of the Aged in Chennai, Family Welfare Agency in Mumbai, and Association for the Care of the Aged in Hyderabad. The role of the state in organizing welfare programs for the elderly is marginal, though some homes for the elderly in India are maintained under the auspice of religious bodies and voluntary organizations. The Christian missionaries, particularly those belonging to the Catholic denomination, have been responsible for starting a large number of homes for the aged. Little Sisters of the Poor, a well-known religious order of nuns with its headquarters in France, maintains many homes for the aged in different states. The Hindu religious and secular groups are also starting residential care programs for the elderly. In its newsletter and brochure on its website, that is www.helpage.india.com, HelpAge India has charted its goals and objectives to work for the cause and care of the older persons, with the ultimate aim of empowering them to make decisions pertaining to their own lives. It seeks to improve the welfare of the aged in India, create an understanding of the changing situations and the needs of the elderly in India and to promote their cause, establish within the younger generations awareness about the problems of the older people in India, raise funds for the creation of infrastructure through the voluntary social service organizations that help the elderly regardless of caste and creed. Mission. The mission of HelpAge India is to work for the cause and care of disadvantaged older persons and to improve their quality of life. Vision. HelpAge India develops, demonstrates, and uses expertise, experience, and resources to animate the stakeholders, including older persons, to fulfill the needs of 1 crore disadvantaged older persons comprehensively across the country. Of these, 2 lakh would be covered directly and 8 lakhs indirectly through partners. During this process, HelpAge India transforms itself into a predominantly rights-based organization, organizes elders and builds movements to demand and exercise their rights and entitlements. Objectives. The objectives of HelpAge India are 1. To foster welfare of the aged in India, especially the needy aged. 2. To raise funds for projects which assist the elderly irrespective of caste or creed. 3. To create in the younger generation and society a social awareness about the problems of the elderly in India today. Features of HelpAge India. HelpAge India features among the leading non-profit organizations of the country. Its activities are oriented towards improving the quality of life for aged persons who are financially insecure and lack the access of healthcare facilities. With wide reach and impact since its inception, HelpAge India has had a positive impact on the lives of over 8 million senior citizens and their families. Its approach is holistic and it provides for immediate relief as well as sustainable improvement in the lives of the destitute elderly. In the year 2004-2005, the organization supported 17,364 cataract surgeries and provided medical care for 1.04 million elders through well-equipped medical mobile healthcare vans. Effective partnerships in development. HelpAge India has evolved as a development support agency. It meticulously chooses partner agencies for prospective funding. Most of the projects developed by HelpAge are implemented through the partner agencies. High degree charitable commitment. HelpAge India has low overhead and administrative cost. 85% of its funds are utilized for actual program implementation. Focus on efficiency and transparency. Project implementation through partnership increases efficiency and cuts down on overhead cost. To ensure intended fund usage, the partner agencies are thoroughly monitored and impact of the projects are also evaluated. Quality management. Management of HelpAge India is comprised of qualified individuals. Additionally, HelpAge India ensures that all new employees are sensitive to the cause of the organization. HelpAge India runs a gamut of programs that impact the lives of many such needy elders. Programs of HelpAge India Mobile Health Service. This program seeks to provide sustainable healthcare solutions to whole communities. The core of the program is a sponsored mobile health unit. This unit provides primary health care to the elderly while simultaneously using the same resource to educate and inform the community on preventive health care, hygiene, and connect the community to government schemes of health insurance and pension. The plan is to make it a community-led and managed health services program, which will remain in place after the sponsored mobile health unit does not operate after 3 years. Presently, there are 110 mobile health units covering 104 districts in 23 states, providing 1.7 million free treatments per annum. Cataract surgeries. In India, 62% elderly suffer from cataract blindness. Credible and competent eye hospitals and organizations working for eye care are selected for carrying out surgeries with HelpAge India support. All surgeries under the program are based only in base hospitals and not in substitute makeshift camps. Since 1980, this program has benefited more than 9 lakh elders, not just restoring their sight, but enabling them to go back to work and live a life of dignity. Cancer and palliative care. Cancer treatment in our country is highly priced and majority of the elders are not covered by any form of medical insurance. HelpAge India provides palliative care to end-stage cancer patients in partnership with a number of credible and competent cancer hospitals and organizations. Over 99,000 are supported since 1998. Geriatric physiotherapy. Under this program, elderly persons with musculoskeletal disease such as back pain, arthritis, and even paralysis and other age-related mobility challenges are treated. The aim of this program is to enable the elderly to support and maintain their fitness and mobility level and make daily living easier, restoring their self-confidence and self-esteem. The services are provided through stationary physiotherapy clinics, mobile services to remote communities, to residents of homes for the aged, and home visits are made by a qualified physiotherapist. Physiotherapy clinics are operational in 90 locations across the country in 23 states. Support an older person. There are thousands of destitute elders who need basic support. Over the years, HelpAge India has enabled more than 30,000 destitute elderly sustain themselves with regular supplies of food, ration, clothing, basic health care, and sometimes provided livelihood opportunities. Disaster relief and rehabilitation. Every disaster impacts the elderly more than others as they have difficulty accessing relief. HelpAge India has stepped in at every major disaster, delivering specialized relief and rehabilitation measures such as during the floods in Tamil Nadu, Uttarakhand, Kashmir, Bihar, and earthquakes in Gujarat, Jammu and Kashmir, etc. Old age homes or daycare centers. A roof over their heads is a critical need of the elder, destitute, sick and abandoned by family and those uprooted by disasters. HelpAge India has established model homes for the elderly in places such as Patiala and Gurudaspur in Punjab, Kudalur in Tamil Nadu and Kolkata and West Bengal. Besides these, HelpAge has also supported over 60 old age homes across India. Livelihood opportunities. To enhance elder capacities, HelpAge India mobilizes them through the formation of elder self-help groups that are centered on sustainable methods of income generation. These elder self-help groups are then federated into high level of community institution so that they gain additional robustness. This model of HelpAge India has been adopted by the Ministry of Rural Development, and HelpAge has been designated as the National Resource Organization for Elderly by the National Rural Livelihoods Mission. Currently, this program covers more than 60,000 elders across India. Elder helplines. The number is 1-800-180-1253. HelpAge toll-free elder helpline across 21 states of India offer assistance to older persons in need of emergency care and protection. The services offered are rescue of abandoned elders, counseling those in distress, legal support, information related to services available, etc. The helpline works as coordination unit linking elders to various institutions such as old age homes, hospitals, geriatric specialists, police, government and non-governmental organizations. Thamaraikulam Elders Village. Thamaraikulam Elders Village is a unique rehabilitation project situated on the Kardalur Puducherry Road, Tamil Nadu, built by HelpAge India NDTV viewers after the tsunami in 2004. 100 elder victims of the tsunami devastation found in Thamaraikulam Elders Village are a safe place to live in the form of modern village for elders, which provides health care, professional care, livelihood options and recreational facilities. Advocacy. HelpAge India reaches 1.25 million elders through its various interventions. However, that is 1% of the 100 million elders in India today. To be able to work for the other 99%, HelpAge India needs far greater resources and a consistent support of the society and government in states and center. Rising public awareness and interacting with media, legislators and government to espouse the elderly cause is therefore an essential and continuous activity for HelpAge India. Working with society. Building public awareness on the importance of supporting the elder cause and its related issues is a key objective of HelpAge India. Every year, it invites public participation in walkathons, signature campaigns, street theatre, etc. on International Day of Older Persons, which is on 1st October, and also involves and engages with media in highlighting the evil of elder abuse on World Elder Abuse Awareness Day, which is on 15th June. Regular interaction and meetings are held with senior citizen associations in cities and elder groups in the rural areas. Common cause is found with partners working on other right-based issues such as pension parish, National Association of Street Vendors of India, etc. Working with youth. HelpAge India's Student Action for Value Addition, that is SAVE's SAVE, aims to inculcate care and respect for the elderly through HelpAge India's long-standing program with schools across the country. On the other hand, the Help Unit Generations initiative aims at involving college students and young professionals to engage with elders and regularly keep in touch with them to provide them companionship. Working with government. Sensitizing legislators in governments, both in the states and centrals, has resulted in HelpAge India contributing significantly to the formulation of national policy on older persons and the enactment of Maintenance and Welfare of the Parents and Seniors Act in 2007. Current ongoing advocacy efforts aim at increase an old age pension, inclusion in healthcare insurance and food security for elders. Working with elders. HelpAge India taps the potential of senior citizens in evolving solutions to address their needs. It is currently associated with more than 1,145 senior citizens associations with 14.75 lakh across 20 states. Additionally, seniors are offered counseling for financial assistance schemes like the reverse mortgage scheme and help with wills and legacies of senior citizens. Senior citizens associations are mentored to engage actively with charitable work. Currently, 70 geriatric physiotherapy clinics in 23 states are being managed by senior citizen associations after an initial period of hand-holding by HelpAge India. Digital literacy for elders. The first phase of change in technology makes it difficult for most to keep up, more so with elders who find it almost impossible to keep up with latest gadgets, mobile phones, tablets, etc. This handicap excludes elders from mainstream social fabric. HelpAge has started an easy digital literacy program introducing elders to the online world. Partner associations, organizations, volunteers and interns are encouraged to conduct basic tutorials for elders using the HelpAge handbook for senior citizens, computers and smartphone learning made easy. Advantage card program. This benefit card offers discounts from retail associates on various product services and facilities ranging from health and wellness to holiday homes. It helps the card holder to stretch household budgets, especially of those senior citizens living on limited or fixed income. Currently, there are 1.66 lakh members from over 400 towns in 22 states being offered discounts by more than 6,000 associates across India. HelpAge India is a funding organization that looks for partner agencies that are all able to implement its various projects and programs. Over the past decade, it has changed its orientation from implementing the welfare projects to a greater focus on development. The new emphasis stresses income generation and microcredit projects and programs that strengthen the participation of older persons in the mainstream of Indian society, also an objective of the national policy on older persons. HelpAge India's approach reflects the basic philosophical and structural elements of community development with emphasis on equity, hope, care and social justice, and on leadership, planning, arrangement and social resource allocation.